The normalization committee, led by Moses Mwase, comprises three additional members, Leticia Namutebi, Cecilia Nyakot, and Peace Poskovia. Mwase affirms that serving on the normalization committee is a changing responsibility, emphasizing their primary objective to diligently carry out the assigned tasks.
First of all, it's a very tough assignment to be on a normalization committee. Some of us have had the experience of serving on normalization committees, and it's never a walk in the park. We will do our very best to serve the netball fraternity. We're working very closely with World Netball to ensure that the assignment is executed plainly, if possible. But we have already had a meeting with World Netball, and they've promised to give us all the support we need. We also have the support of stakeholders, especially government, the netball fraternity, who we will continue reaching out to ensure that as much as practically possible, as you know, can be, we get the league going after understanding what it takes, after engaging with sponsors and all people that make that happen. We've only been appointed. We have not even had a lot of time to get into the detail of what is required. So we need a bit of time to understand the assignment, to get plans ready, and then give assurances.
As the chairperson of the UNF Normalization Committee, Mwase highlights on their current responsibilities within the Ugandan Netball Federation.
According to our instrument of appointment from World Netball, I think our main role, first of all, is to do hand-holding in the short run. It's a six-month assignment within which we should help to review the statutes of the federation and also help with an elective assembly.
If prioritization is based on the urgency of the situations, managers would have preferred the league to resume immediately, expressing that its suspension has had a great impact on them.
With all this saga, our sponsors are not happy because some of us got money from different organizations. Me especially from Greenlight Islamic Secondary School. They are too inquisitive. They paid their money for registration. They sponsored us with registration, but they are not getting any value for their money. Reason being, they are not seeing the games on, because they thought they would be advertising, they would be showcasing what they have. There are even other two that might not come back to our team. Reason being, their sponsorship money has not been put to use. Reason being, it was supposed to be put to use when we are playing, but we can't stop. We can't stop paying allowances. We can't stop buying equipment because the league is not on. But these people are not happy. Reason being, their companies have invested into us, but we've given them back nothing in return.
Responding it has obviously affected.